dreadlocks. It shouldn't be a hindrance for me going to school or working in any of that. Then I have to pursue my rights in the courts for them to grant me my permission. But having said that, society has developed standards which does not conform to our natural being or who we are in certain circumstances. And that is why you need to fight who I am. I have a right for my child to any go school, to that any school that I want the child, to go to, and you can't stop me.
Right,
that's right. It's more powerful
than the protocols
of the school. That's why I was just trying to explain to that gentleman. There is a law that gives you a right. The law doesn't say that you have to be a guardian or entitled. You're entitled to that right. So if anybody's trying to superior. That fights against the protocols of a school. So we take it out.
And other places have taken it up, haven't they? Precisely. It's a battle.
That we have to get things done properly. So that's my position. But you need to be careful when the president makes an executive order, which is entitled to a law, to make that order. As much as he's entitled to make that order, he is entitled also to change that order. So if you are pursuing in that course, you need to be very careful and very skilled to get him to the corner where he cannot reverse. You get me? Yes, you tread cautiously. And then you make sure that you beat him to that corner where the public law or civil law can deal with the issue. Even he has to go to that. Otherwise, it's okay. Look, I'll grant it anyway because it's not politically correct for me to pursue this course of action. Okay? So I need you to understand it. Otherwise, we have problems. I don't want you to go and hit against a law. If you hit against the law, they will all run away from you and you cannot move because the law of the land. You don't want to do that. So you tread cautiously. If they say you need resident permit, come to me and I'll make sure I get you one.
Yeah. He's saying really a mouthful. And there's one other thing, Barrister, that I think that needs to be put on the table here. You see, we're dealing with a third party threat. Now, you have to understand this, that there are certain powers that be. I'm not talking about Ghana. I mean outside of Ghana, even outside the African continent. Let's talk about the EU, the European Union. We talk about Canada, United States of America. They do not, as much as the US has said, niggas go back to Africa. Those of us who know and have lived there know they don't want black folks to leave the United States and come back to Africa. They don't want it. But now, here is the sensitive threat. While council is trying to get us, and we shall get the Citizenship Act of Parliament, we will get it. But while doing that, if any of us were to go astray, you understand what I'm saying, and contravene the laws of the land and create a diplomatic, you know what I mean, a diplomatic problem. Those people who do not want us to come are going to go through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the land that we are in and say, I told you so. They are problems. Don't deal with them.
It shouldn't be a hindrance.
And most likely, that government would close the door on us. And that would be the end of the right to return. I don't know if you're getting me with what I'm saying. So when he said you have to be tread cautiously, you know what I mean? It's challenging in the Constitution of God. I remember that when I became a citizen. It said that the president preserves the right to approve or disapprove.
Right. That's right.
That is the preserve of the president.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Alicia Rivers, and I'm going to give my brief before I speak so that you guys won't get confused that I'm a small girl, okay? Because I've 10 years in the United States Marine Corps and the United States Army, and I have my 14 African-American daughters currently living in Ghana. As an African American, if any of us are allowed to say they are African American, it's a psychology thing. We have a culture that's mirrored here as it is everywhere in the world. From African American community, my psychological mental health, which nobody's anybody talking about. Public service announcements, your average man don't even know the history of this country. To even talk to us, to accept and understand what happened. Right? So when we come here, I haven't heard one thing about our mental health. I haven't heard one thing about what we actually contribute outside of money as an African American. As an African American, I contribute knowledge, I contribute my ideas, I contribute a lot of things that have been, the door that have been closed to it in Africa. Yes, I learned things from
Come on, 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 come on Karaoke for Young Line. blogspot.com